pipes aren't lining up.
What do you mean the pipes aren't lining up?
They're not lining up.
Dude, that's like 2 inches lower than the other pipe. Did you measure it?
I measured
did
it.
Did you even measure it?
I measured it.
Dude, this whole crate is ruined. We're going to have to make a whole nother crate. We drilled that, it's done. Dang! We're just kidding, man. This isn't West Coast Choppers. Home Depot has got a solution for everything. Okay, we just got back from Home Depot, and instead of using this straight coupler right here, we got this flexible coupler that'll flex so that we can deal with this. Thanks, Chris. I blamed you for that mess up, but I'm actually the one who messed it up. Thanks for the drama. Welcome to our phase one greenhouse aquaponic system set up to grow 1,000 fish. We've got 6 of these tanks plumbed together, each holding various rates of growth of fish for a continuous harvest. In the back, we've got our Vortex filters I'll tell you about later. But first, let's hit some basics. Aquaponics is the merging of 2 farming technologies. You've got hydroponics and aquaculture. Hydroponics is growing plants without soil in water, like we got here. And aquaculture is fish farming.
This is a symbiotic relationship where the fish fertilize the plants with their waste. The plants use that fertilizer, soak it up, and send the water back clean to the fish to reuse. Some of the other benefits of aquaponics are the free organic fertilizer we get every day, the optimal growing environment for the plants, and the freshest fish and veggies to your plate on the earth.
So the best way to learn aquaponics is to learn the principles. Once you figure out the principles, you can build the system any way you like to fit your goals using whatever materials you can find in whatever country you're in.
So whether you want to build a small basement system with 40-gallon totes that will give you salad greens every day for your family, or if you want to build a backyard system with 1,000 fish and multiple grow beds, or a large-scale production system, it's all the same principles. So principle number 1, get connected. Post any questions you have in our forum. We want to help you. Visit our growing database of technical information at TheUrbanFarmingGuys.com. Join us. There's a bunch of like-minded people there who want to help you out. Okay, that wasn't a principle, but the most important thing you need to be concerned with when you're building your system is water quality. You want to keep the ammonia low, the oxygen high, and the temperature right, and we're going to show you just how that happens. A lot of people ask, how many pounds of fish can you put in your system per gallon of water? Well, fish excrete toxic ammonia. The answer to that question is highly determined on how quickly your system handles that ammonia. So rather than flush that water down the drain, aquaponics takes advantage of the ammonia. It's called the nitrogen cycle, and it takes place right here. It's all about building your system to host the most healthy bacteria. The fish excrete the toxic ammonia compound. The bacteria immediately eat the ammonia, turn it into nitrite. And another bacteria comes along, eats the nitrite, converts it into nitrate, which is then absorbed by the plants as fertilizer. So that poses 2 questions. How do you build your system to host the most bacteria? And where do you get that bacteria in the first place? The amount of bacteria that your system can host is directly proportionate to the amount of surface area your system has. This particular bacteria needs surface area to colonize. That's what the rocks are good for. Besides stabilizing the plants, they create a huge amount of surface area. And you can increase this in several other ways. You can build a trickle filter, a sand filter. We built a bead filter with 100 pounds of beads tumbling around, creating a massive amount of surface area. We're going to talk about these in the forums. Come check it out. Ask questions. We're going to help you out with this. So where do you get the bacteria in the first place? Well, it's there. You can't avoid it. Once you start adding ammonia to the system, the bacteria will start to colonize. But you can speed up the process by taking a filter or some rocks from an existing system and introduce it to the new system to get going. Next, we're going to talk about filtration. You can go as big or as small as you want on this.
These guys right here are Vortex filters. Retail, they'd be about $4,000 a piece. DIY version, about $100. You might be able to do it for cheaper. We've got a 55-gallon drum with a cone built into it down into a shower drain. Out here, you can pull off your fertilizer every day for your garden. I'll show you about that. We've got an incredible fertilizer.
We have a pretty intense system, so we built some really intense filtration. but you'll want to think about these processes. Stage one, you want to settle out as much of the solids as you can before you send it to your mechanical filter, so you don't have to change your filter pads all the time. So we built this vortex filter where the water spins real slow, the solids settle to the bottom, we pull them off as fertilizer every day. Stage two, whatever solids sneak by get caught in four filter pads so that the only thing left to filter now is the ammonia. Stage three is the biological filter. It's where you create a lot of surface area for bacteria to grow. Ours is a bead filter. You might do a sand filter or a trickle filter. After stage three, the ammonia is turned into nitrate. It's pumped up to the plants. In stage four, the plants use the nitrate and send it back clean. And you could do this on a much simpler level. We wouldn't even need the vortex filters if we just had 100 fish instead of 1,000. The rocks in the grow bed would do most of the biological filtration, and we just have to clean it out, whatever solids got caught up in there. But we are on a mission to create organic fertilizer and harvest it.
We just pulled some concentrated fish manure out of our filtration system, and we're going to test it. We're going to take it up to the University of Missouri and find out what's in it. We know it's full of nitrogen. It's great for the garden, but is it everything? Is it missing anything? You know, how far do you spread it? How much do you need to dilute it? We're going to get the results from MU and get back to you in the next episode.
We got those results back from MU. It looks to be an incredible fertilizer, 962, full of micronutrients, potent enough to fertilize about 20 tomato plants a day, come back and fertilize 20 more. We're posting the full analysis in our database on the website. Come check it out. And lastly, if you don't really care how it works, you just want to download some plans and a part list so you can build it, we got a growing database of open source information.
Now at the end of the day, when you're almost completely wiped out, take a grape, cut that thing in half, leave a little skin there, 5 seconds in the microwave, boom, burst into flames. I don't know why. Tell me why. Hit up the internet, hit the comment board, make Red's day.
What do you think about that?